Do you find yourself stuck trying to come up with new t-shirt ideas and designs? Or maybe you just want an endless stream of fresh prompts to expand your creative options? Well, in today's video, I'm going to show you how to unlock a limitless t-shirt prompt generator using two of the hottest AI tools out there, ChatGPT and Ideogram. Give this video a thumbs up. Let's get into the content.
Now, when it comes to generating prompts for Ideogram, this is the free way to generate unlimited prompts. So what we're going to use is two different things in here. We're using ChatGPT, and then we're going to use this Chrome extension called AIPRM for ChatGPT. Now, this is a free Chrome extension. Obviously, they have a paid subscription model too as well, if you really like it. But for the most part, the free version does a lot. But, you know, with certain things like this, there's benefits to using the paid subscription. But for you can get a lot done by using the free version. And you're seeing like one of the, you know, prompt generators right here, the Midjourney prompt generator, which is a really, really good one. You can see it has 1.8 million views, 1.2 million comments, and then the thumbs up. They're just a, you know, this is obviously by looking at this, you can see that this seems to be good. And, you know, by the thumbs up, the views and the comments on it itself. Now, if we come in here, there's the Ideogram one, you can see it's right here. And then if you want to mess around with the Midjourney one, because they're pretty much they're very similar as far as like creating image AI, like AI images, right? You can see there's a ton for Midjourney because it's been around a little bit longer than Ideogram. So if we come over here, we type in Ideogram, you can use any of those ones too. But for this example, we'll go ahead and use this one. So let's go ahead and let's say Santa t-shirt. Let's say t-shirt design, and then we're just going to go ahead and hit next, and it's going to go ahead and generate that prompt for us. And this is, you know, there's several, you can do that with the Midjourney one, you can do it with this one, there's a lot that can be done right here. So go ahead and let it, you know, generate the prompt for us. And you can even put like certain text in there if you want to put like a certain text saying, you can do that too as well. Now we're going to go ahead and take one of these, we're going to copy this, go ahead and copy that, and then we're going to come over here to Ideogram, and then we're going to clear that, hit that, enter, or generate. And it generated two, by the way. It generated four different prompts. So if you see right there, there's five different prompts. So there's a lot that can be done with this and the different ideas. And one way that I recommend you do research is think of trending holidays that are coming up. Christmas, Halloween, Thanksgiving, Easter, New Year's Day, anything. You can think anything, any type of animal, any type of hobby, anything like that, any occupation, anything that there's a demand in, you can definitely come in here and just use the search bar and type something in, and then it'll generate a prompt for you. Still generating. Boom, there it is. So Santa Claus theme t-shirt design, you're seeing exactly what it did. It broke, you know, vibrant colors, cheerful festive atmosphere, really cool. I'm thinking like Santa Claus with a boombox. Let me go ahead and try that. So let me see, like Santa Claus with a boom box. And then you can think of like a saying, like a text saying like, this is how I do it. You know what I mean? Put text. This is how, and then I'm gonna go ahead and hit enter, and you can see it's generating. All right, generating, still going. And we're just brainstorming right now. Just think of one idea after another. And I'm just like, you know what? That was a cool design. Let me just try this. And you can see what it came up with. Santa Claus holding a boombox, confidence and stylish, playful expression, snowy winter night background, laminated by a colorful neon lights. And then it goes on and on and on. It says the text, this is how I do. Bring it back over here. These ones are good, by the way. And keep in mind too, you can also do research just by looking at, you know, what's trending recent top and seeing how people like certain things and see like, you know, just the different ideas, so many different ideas that can be come up with inside of here. So let's clear this, put that one, and generate. Now, you're gonna see, you know, see what it generated. Maybe, you know, t-shirt design, vector design, you know, adding a few more different keywords inside of here. So, and you see if I come back over here to the, you know, the different prompt, we have four more to go, right? So we have a total of five different prompts that were created right there. And just adding little keywords as I go along. So like say, like, you know, I don't want with the vector text in. So vector t-shirt, right? Design. And you know, I kind of messed that out, but maybe Santa Claus with a boombox vector t-shirt design text. This is how I do. And maybe just re-edit that right there. I think it's still good though. Like this is clean. This is pretty cool, right? But what do you know? Is a t-shirt design enough? Or even like depending on what you're doing, right? It could be anything. If you're making like a postcard, if you're making a sticker, just keep in mind like different things that you're creating It all depends like how you're doing it, and you just want to understand like how you would talk to it. All right, let's grab that one, clear that, and it's going to go ahead and generate the new prompt that we just created. And if you're unaware too, like I said right here, when you're looking at these different images, each prompt is going to be down below these images. So if you like a certain idea, if you see a certain keyword that's standing out to you that you want to use in your prompt, you can definitely do that. Now, so it's done and completed it. This one's pretty cool. This is how, I know it's missing the eye. The eye kind of went over here, but I would put that over here. I like the style and like the flow of this design. That looks pretty cool. This is how, this one right here, this is how I do it. Interesting. No, I would keep messing with it, maybe like regenerate it, come up with different ideas, but this is some really good stuff so far. Like this right here, I think it's pretty clean. You just maybe have to do a little few edits with this and bring it over. And in the video, the next video, and this is pretty clean, you know, see, you can see how you can just move this eye over. But I think this is the good starting point, and you can come up with a ton of different prompt ideas over here, you know, just based off over here. And this is all free that I'm sharing with you right here. So a really good idea to generate tons and tons of different prompts. If you run out of different ideas, or if you don't know how to talk to the AI over here, you can definitely create some cool designs based off of using ChatGPT and Ideogram.
If you want to learn how to edit out the background and upscale these images, watch this video right here. Thank you very much for watching. Peace out.